I could really use that.
You tell Mindy the story of how Hetch found the gem.
That's awfully nice of him. You know, people lose coins all the time when running around the hedge maze in Unicorn Way. You should look there.
Find a coin lying on the ground.
So, could Professor Greyrose use that gem? Wow, you found my lucky coin. Thank you so much.
Thank you. So you're the outlander everyone speaks of, eh? The one who has done so many great things. Oh, my pardon. I know the ebb and tides of fate, and I have seen your destiny. My mind is wide and open to the forces of the universe. But I can no longer see your fate. Not unless you help me fetch the ingredients for a potion. You would have my thanks eternal. If you will do an old raven a favor, go into the burial ground and seek mandrake root from the ground there.
What brings you to the camp of Bjorn Ironclaws? Bjorn sent you? He wants us to teach you our ways and see if you're worthy of joining our band? Fair enough. If you wish to learn our ways and join this band, you must learn to be fearless at all times. Fear profits you nothing. Your destiny was woven long ago, and nothing you do can escape fate. It is best to meet challenges with courage in your heart and a blade in your hand. I do not know if you are cowardly or courageous. Only you know which. Go to our old burial ground and defeat 3 troubled warriors. Return then and tell me what was in your heart.
Yeah.
You dig up the mandrake root. It almost seems to squirm as you hold it, like a living being, but then it grows still. You dig up the mandrake root. It almost seems to squirm as you hold it, like a living being, but then it grows still.
We heard the troubled warrior's howls from here. Were you fearful, or were you fierce? Speak the truth, or I will know if you do not. Good then. That's what I like to hear. Stay courageous. Luck may save you sometimes, but only if your courage holds. A hero is nothing without his reputation, and a great part of that reputation comes from the deeds of his father. You're an outsider, though. And no one knows who your father was. So we must get a great hero to speak highly of you, as if you were his own child. Go back into the burial ground, to the mound of Ingvar Sharptooth. Convince him that you're a worthy heir to his reputation.
Stinkweed for this potion. Look around Colossus Boulevard and see if you can find some. Pikeweed really does stink. I know I've lost my appetite. That's all I need. I'll brew the potion now. Here's the first batch of potion, young wizard. Hopefully this will make the gobblers stop eating. While I'm making more, go beat some gobblers in combat and make them drink the stinkweed potion. Had any effect. I'm gonna go out on a limb and say the potion didn't quite work. I don't want to bother the headmaster. I know. The Gobbler King lives in the large palace at the very end of the street. Maybe we can reason with him. I'll try to brew a stronger potion. See if you can make a deal with the Gobbler King to stop eating and leave the city.
So, Malorn Ashthorn wants me to rate your fighting skills? Okay, I've done that many times for him before. I talked to him because I was once a death student. Problem was, I was too scared of ghosts. How about you go and defeat some gobblers? They are pretty tough for the Wizard City area. I would not want to go up against any.
Thank you.
Impressive indeed. You seem to be living up to your reputation as a death student. I just wish I could have made it as a student when I was young. Here, take the note to Malorn Ashthorn. I gave you 5 out of 5 gold stars for your effort. Keep up the studies, young wizard.
Thank you. You'll have to get past me if you want to see the king.
the first world, the children of Lady Nightstar, the Grandmother Raven, battled constantly. Titans they were, embodiments of ice, fire, and storm. Their conflict shook the world, but by the time of the Spiral, only their offspring remained. Giants were the descendants of the Ice Titan, who used his power to create frost castles from frozen clouds. Like their ancestor, they battled the dragons on the ground until the wars decimated both races. The giants retreated to the world now known as Grizzleheim, where the few who still remain rule the frigid realm of Wintertusk.
A tiny wizard. Hello, tiny wizard. Have you come to surrender your city? You want us to leave? Oh, no. No, no, no. My people love it here. We shall call this city New Gobbleton. If you prove to be good servants, perhaps we shall let the tiny wizard stay in New Gobbleton. Here is my royal decree.
You pick up the royal decree to take back to Mindy Pixie Crown.
The Gobbler King wants us to surrender Wizard City? Big problem! Big problem! I can't believe the Gobblers are trying to claim Wizard City! We need to tell Headmaster Ambrose. Take the Gobbler King's royal decree to Headmaster Ambrose. See what he thinks we should do.
Thank you. What? This decree doesn't even make sense. It's just pictures of ice cream and chickens drawn in crayon.
Headmaster Ambrose shakes his head sadly.
The gobblers may be a larger problem than we realized. I hate to ask, but you need to go duel some of them to test their strength. As you know, the other faculty members and I are quite impressed with your performance here at Ravenwood School. So much so that we would like you to travel abroad as a representative of the best Wizard City has to offer. You will compete in a magical tournament, dueling students from other magic schools for the ultimate prize, the Spiral Cup. Sadly, Ravenwood hasn't taken the cup in a long, long while, but we can't give up trying. Please report to Mr. Lincoln in Ravenwood. He can provide you with all the details.
Hello there, young wizard. I've been expecting you. The Ravenwood School of Magic must send a student wizard to participate in a spiral-wide tournament of magic. This tournament is a very prestigious event, a chance for students across the spiral to compete for their school's honor. The tournament is held at Pigswick Academy, a rival school to Ravenwood, located on the world of Wisteria. After reviewing all eligible students, Headmaster Ambrose and the other professors chose you to be our representative. You will need this ring to show that you're our champion, the student to defend Ravenwood's honor in the tournament.
Mr. Lincoln hands you a heavy ring with an emblem of Bartleby inscribed upon it.
Be sure to put that somewhere safe, mind you. Perhaps lock it away in a drawer. It's too precious to carry around loose. Now the spiral door will take you to Wisteria. When you get there, see the Pigswick Academy Registrar, Mrs. Dowager. She'll get you set up and see that you're taken care of. Good luck!
Yeah.
Good. Now that we know how strong the gobblers are, I have a plan. Please deliver this letter to Mindy Pixie Crown for me. Your hard work will pay off, I promise.
Headmaster Ambrose hands you an official-looking document. Mindy Pixie Crown reads the official-looking document.
I think this plan will work. This plan calls for challenging the Gobbler King's two closest advisors, Baron Greebly and Baron Rotunda. Dueling isn't my strength, so you're the only one who can do this, young wizard. They're each hiding out in towers, one at each end of the street. Defeat them and see what the Gobbler King has to say then.
Is it time for dinner yet? You look like you'd make a good stew. Get over here!
Thank you. You've come to take away my treats? I can't allow that. To battle!
Ah, the little wizard is back. Are you ready to surrender now?
You tell the Gobbler King about your battles with Barons Greebly and Rotunda.
What? You defeated them? I find that hard to believe. I'll have to send someone to find out if what you say is true or not.
Just as the Gobbler King is getting ready to call, a messenger breaks into the room.
Sir, the two barons have been defeated by a student wizard. What shall we do?
Oh, dear. What you said is true. Then that means New Gobbleton, a wizard city, is yours. Spare me and my people, wizard. We mean you no harm. I ask that we are allowed to stay here. Our old home was filled with witches, and we are too scared to go back. I promise we will not eat so much. You have my word.
Thank you.
Amazing, young wizard. You have brought peace with the gobblers. You've done a great job. Be sure to tell Headmaster Ambrose what the Gobbler King said. Now I can get back to my project.
My plan worked. Oh, that's excellent news.
You tell Headmaster Ambrose what the Gobbler King said about their home world.
My, my. I certainly don't want to force them to go back to a world where they aren't welcome. Very well. We will let them stay on Colossus Boulevard. It appears we have new neighbors.
So it seems that Kirby was impressed with your performance, and that you're becoming a talented wizard. Your next spell is called Death Prism. You will need the Scroll of the Elder Seer to complete this quest. I heard that a clue to the location of the scroll is somewhere near Mortis, the Death Tree, in a secret place called Nightside. You'll know it when you see it.
You feel the ground begin to rumble.
So, you are looking for the spell scroll? It is inside the tower across the street. Unfortunately, it is well guarded by Nightstalker and Adair Tameo. Be careful, young wizard. This will be a tough battle. Good luck.
What is this? A visitor? You'll never get the scroll of the Elder Seer.
Ah, I see you found the scroll of the Elder Seer. Very good. Let me see it.
You give the scroll to Malorn Ashthorn, who immediately starts reading it.
Yes, this is the scroll of the Elder Seer. And for that, here is your next death spell.
Ah!